So today is day one and we are heading off to Newport in South Wales to see Murder Club. Day one comes with the excitement of starting the whole project, but the anxiety of, does everything work? Have I forgotten to bring a charger cable or anything else? So yeah, it's going to be the first time everything all gets plugged in together and the first session to record. So yeah, fingers crossed.
Already feel like I'm getting too old to waste all of my time. Can't face the guilt when I know half my life's not even mine to decide.
My name's Tom, and I run No Luck Audio, a recording studio in Exeter. We're taking the studio on the road to meet five underground bands around the UK, find out why they do what they do, despite sometimes feeling futile. Sometimes I wanna be bold. Yeah, I'm feeling excited about the tour. I've got an idea of how I think sort of things are gonna go, but they never do, and I'm really interested to find out sort of other people's experiences and how they've sort of made their way or are making their way through music as a hobby, pastime, career. Tonight I'm feeling.
I've always wanted to be in a band since I was a teenager, but because there was no one else that I saw doing it, I just thought it wasn't really an option. I think the hardest thing was like getting the confidence to do it. You don't see, like, I don't know of any other bands really that are all women.
We are Murder Club. We are a band from Newport, South Wales, and we play music. I was living in Exeter and I went to a thing called School of Frock that they did in the Cavern, which was like only like women or like non-binary people, and you just like got taught an instrument for the day. And I think like having something like that where it's like you can do it, it's okay, like come and we'll help you, is just like so important. Me and Ellie had been in bands and like we were like, Lily, you can be in a band with us, it's allowed. Yeah. And then Alicia started hanging out in the same pub as all of us and could drum. I texted them both like right away. I was like, I've got a drummer.
I felt at home sort of straight away. Like, I feel like we gel together so well, and I've never had that with any other band before, so I think it's definitely the way. Yeah. It was a blessing, I think.
I quite like with doing a band that you get to like show people, like loads of people at once, and see them enjoying it, doing something that we've created together and like being proud of it.
Yeah.
And like when we write a song, I'm like, we wrote that whole song, all of us. And it's just really nice to like have that as like our thing. And like even like with like the image of it and like everything around the band, like our pictures and everything, it's us.
Thank you.
The music scene in Newport does mainly exist in the pub, but it is like, it's still really like thriving even though it's just one venue. And it's been so important to all of us. Like, we realised earlier that for me, Ellie and Lily, this was where we did our first ever gig, all three of us separately. And it's like how we became friends and this, yeah, so.
How we met really.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Newport is like forgotten about a lot, but as a place it's quite well connected. You've got a lot of people here that can help you with things and get you to know other good people.
It's good for us because a lot of bands don't get that, like when they're starting out they just coast for ages, where I feel like we came out of lockdown and then we've just like been on
we've been ready
ever since.
Well, I think we're in a pretty unique situation.
Yeah,
we already know a lot of people who are willing to give us gigs.
But I think as well that's just such like a big testament to the DIY scene, is that like once you know the people and they like they've seen me and Ellie like maybe in our other bands, and they're like, oh, I know they're nice people,
I'll just give you the gigs.
I'll just put them on, like they don't know what we sound like. We've got no recorded music out. People are just like, do you want to play? And it's like, yes please, thank you.
There's not many bands around who are all female, so I think that gives us an opportunity.
If we had, obviously we weren't old enough, but if we had done this 10 years ago, I think it would have been very different, but people are a lot more accepting now, and like there's not like that assumption that you must be with someone else.
I feel like that's helped us.
Yeah, it does.
So
like
getting like offers and things, I think it's because there's an all-female band. The hardest part, I think, is probably is that working jobs.
Our schedules are literally like as opposite as you can get. Like, we're all free Thursday at 6 o'clock for 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Basically. But I do think that everyone should be in a band because it's loads of fun.
Loads of fun. Go to gigs.
Like,
make yourself known as just as a person.
Yeah, and then like, you'll meet someone who then in 2 years' time ends up putting you on, but you've just literally got to speak to people and like get out there and make yourself known in your community, wherever that is. If you've like got one in your town or you have to go to like the nearest city, you've just got to make yourself a part of it. Just don't be a dick, because if as soon as you're like late or you don't care or you like show any kind of disrespect somewhere, then like they're not going to want to book you again. Like our very first gig, we got off stage and the venue rep was like, you went on at stage time and you came off at the end of your stage time and I love you so much. And I was like, that's why we need to keep going. That's the reputation that I want.
So I think it was really interesting listening to what Murder Club had to say and their experiences. Obviously their experiences differ greatly from mine, but one thing that they had that was a real parallel with my experience is like the importance of community. So they were saying about how, you know, if you're respectful and you turn up on time and you treat people well and, you know, let people borrow your equipment, whatever, do those things you say you're gonna do, then people treat you with respect. That to me is like one of the most interesting and sacred parts of music and my experience as to why I really like to make it. I feel like it's the only time that I engage in a community that does something for nothing.
Well, I feel like what stood out to me is the fact that none of them initially, when they were younger, no matter what age that was, felt like they had that role model of women-led bands, or you know, women in making actual like punk rock rather than just being a pop star or being in like a girl band, and now they're doing it, they're like, oh, actually it's a massive benefit being an all-girl or all-female band.
So it's 8 o'clock on day one and we are just about to leave Newport and head to Bournemouth. We might stick our heads in and see Murder Club play a couple of songs very quickly.
They're literally just heading on stage now.
Yeah, they're literally going to be on stage in 1 minute and 14 seconds. And then, and then we're going to see Julia, who is stage name Juju. She's very kindly going to let us stay there for 2 nights. So we're going to make some progress now and obnoxiously arrive very late at her property and disturb everyone who lives there. So that will be a good first impression.
Be great.